Hello, ladies. Last night was really emotionally charged, and Oliver had to send Nicole home, which was really hard, but he's ready to move on, and he sent you this letter.
Chantal, Renee, Morgan, Ella, join me on a trip around the city.
What do you think we're doing?
The two-on-one date was the most difficult decision of my life, but I felt a strong connection with both girls, and I had to send one home. I'm just really ready to move forward and have a great day with the girls. I really feel a close connection with New York City. I know that since a lot of people emigrated through Ellis Island and I immigrated, that I feel a bond there. And the bus tour is going to be a great way to see who's in it for the long haul, who really cares about this relationship.
Well, ladies, after London, Newcastle, York, Manchester and Sheffield, New York's the greatest city in the world, so I thought we'd go and see the sights. Let's go!
Hey, let's go!
Yeah, I'm up at Brooklyn. Now I'm down in Tribeca, right next to the Narrow, but I'll be hood forever.
Look at the Statue of Liberty!
No way!
So I got some one-on-one time with Oliver on the boat ride, and he showed me the Statue of Liberty, and he was like, "You're my Statue of Liberty, like you're my Lady Liberty." It was so romantic.
Oliver took me aside at the Brooklyn Bridge, and we shared a hug. It was easily the most romantic hug of my life.
How about a hug?
I've never been on a bus this big, and I'm having a great day.
You hear the trains going up there? English invented the train. Yeah.
Oliver's like really smart. He knows everything.
Englishman. We sort of discovered China and invented Chinese food. So what do you like most about the city?
Well, I like the shopping, but I mostly like being here with you.
This place is so gorgeous. So we were at the park and Chantal was acting really weird. I mean, like she normally is, but this time I had some one-on-one time with Oliver and she totally ruined it.
Oliver, Chantal needs you.
Oh, I'll be right there. Sorry.
Hi.
Are you okay?
Just, my ankle hurts and I don't know, these girls have just been so mean to me. They don't like me and I don't know why. And
I'm really sorry. I know there's more to you than that. I'll be right back.
To have Oliver come and make me and my ankle feel better was just amazing. And when he gave me that rose, it was just the cap to a perfect day.
I cannot believe he gave Chantal the rose. Like, how does he not see right through her? She's totally not here for the right reasons.
Well, Katie showed up yesterday and I was completely taken aback. But I knew there were feelings there. So I'm going to ask her on the one-on-one date in New York, in Central Park. I think it's the right thing to do.
I was the only one who didn't go on the group date, so I'm thinking that I might be getting some one-on-one time.
Oliver told me to give this to you.
Oh my gosh, a carriage!
I don't know what I'm looking for. You know, I feel like it's fate that she showed up. I hope I can see a sign.
I take you on a ride on a carriage lift through New York. Carriages are the predominant mode of transport because when Henry Ford invented the motor vehicle, he didn't want them in England, so we still use carriages, but it's nice.
It's really romantic.
Yeah. Well, how have you been?
Good. I've been at Michigan State and it's going really well.
Nice.
Yeah.
What do you do at Michigan State?
I go to class and hang out with my friends sometimes. Just have fun, you know.
Wow, that's exciting.
Yeah.
As I'm talking to Katie, I can't help shake the feeling that our lives have gone in different trajectories. I mean, I like her. She's beautiful. But I think our time has passed.
Why did you come back?
Well, I really thought we had this deep connection, and I just from seeing you on TV, I knew that there was something there, and I knew I couldn't let that chance pass me by.
Well, See, I can't stop this feeling that it's awkward, that we missed our opportunity, and...
Why would it be awkward?
I don't think I can give you this rose. I'm sorry.
Why not?
I just can't.
I don't understand. I thought I made the right decision. I really thought we had something, but I guess it's just back to being alone up at Michigan State.
Letting go of Katie was the hardest decision I've had to make on the show. In fact, the hardest decision of my life, and I'm just really torn. I still don't know if I made the right decision.
There will come a time you'll see, with no more tears and love will not break your heart, but dismiss your fears, get over your hill and see what you find there with grace in your heart and flowers in your hair.
Burns, will you accept this rose?
Sure.
Oh, great.